All right, this is Bruce Posner of Terp Talk with the post-game show here tonight. UMES with my main man, Rick Jaklich, and of course, Wayne Viner on the camera tonight. Well, Rick, Logan Ehrenhardt's the story tonight.
Gotta love those threes, just bombing them from the outside. Makes everybody look better, doesn't he?
You know, tonight started five guys, a little unusual lineup. You had Padge, you had Jake Layman and Shaq, different guys in the lineup. Des Wells, I think he wanted to get Layman and he wanted to get Shaq some real minutes.
And they did that. Shaquille Clear had 10 points in that first part of the first half. Looked good, rebounded well. Then they brought a whole new five in. UMES has only 9 players total. Just warmed down before the first quarter was over, really.
A little disappointed in the crowd tonight, Rick. It was maybe half filled, but I guess the opponent might have dictated it.
Now, where are the students? Where are the students? Come on, students. What's the deal?
It's not finals week yet, is it?
It's not. They should be here. And if it is, come here, watch the game, then go to the library.
As everybody's falling out early after this easy win tonight, Terps moved to 7-1. And you were right last week. You called me after the Terps beat Northwestern. What did you say? Carolina will still be ranked over us. And yes, they're still ranked over us.
Well, they looked so good in that game against Indiana. And, you know, we kind of struggled with Northwestern. We only beat them by, 25 points. So you can see that, right?
The biggest game so far this week, or maybe in the past couple weeks, is Northwestern beating Baylor at Baylor, who had defeated Kentucky. That's going to raise us quickly in the Sagarin RPI poll. I don't know what it'll do in the rankings, but that is a huge game for where we sit in the standings.
Well, you and I have talked about the big problem with the rankings is some of the people that vote don't watch the games.
Yeah, I agree, but, you know, the Kentucky loss doesn't look like a good game anymore because Kentucky's getting killed by everybody.
You know, Church had an interesting comment about that. He says everybody said to him, boy, good thing you're playing Kentucky first game of the year. And instead, it turns out, good thing Kentucky played Maryland before Maryland got going.
That's exactly right. I mean, Kentucky, we were sloppy that game. Turnovers, I don't know what the final number will be tonight, but it certainly was a little bit better. All in all, a good game. And again, next game, Wayne, is Saturday at 2:30 against South Carolina State. I assume they're in South Carolina. I'm not sure where.
I think they are. And then next Wednesday, it's Monmouth.
Monmouth, okay. Well, let's give some credit to Dustin Clark
for scheduling.
Being 7-1 right now. look, you play who's before you. They've done great. So it's a good win tonight. They look good. They were steady and clean. And I it was enjoyable. But we're waiting to that first game in January against Virginia Tech.
You know, when Dustin schedules a game, you don't know how good the Terps are going to be. You didn't know you're going to have Wells. You didn't know you're going to have a lot of these players. Boy, they look sharp tonight.
Yeah, and Wells was, he didn't get that many minutes. Neither did Len. Neither did Payshon. So he kind of gave everybody a shot. They paid off. That's it. This is Bruce Posner. It'll be up on Thursday morning with Rick Jaklich and Wayne Viner. And we'll see you tomorrow night on Terp Talk from Baltimore, Coons Ford Terp Talk, and Saturday on Kelly and Associates Insurance Group Terp Talk, where we're going to have a little Ravens-Redskins Beltway battle between us, all right? And that'll wrap it up. Thanks a lot, Rick. Thank you, Wayne.